Hello, everyone. I'm Lavanya Lakshman, product manager on the Microsoft Intune product focused on AI-driven analytics. And now hand it over to my colleague, Zach.
Hey, team. I'm Zach Dvorak. I'm a product manager on the Intune team here at Microsoft, and I focus on analytics scenarios. Today, we're going to talk about how you can prioritize your end user's technology experience with some advanced features for endpoint analytics. For starters, I'll give you a brief overview of endpoint analytics in case you're not familiar with what that is, and then we'll talk about some of the advanced features that we've released as part of Microsoft Intune Suite. We'll jump into some demos where Lavanya and I will walk you through the new features that are available, and then Lavanya will wrap up with a call to action. So for those that aren't familiar, endpoint analytics is an Intune feature that allows you to address end-user pain points before end-users report them. You can proactively remediate issues and remove some of those productivity blockers that can help you optimize your corporate PCs. When we talk to IT pros about their endpoint management challenges, we hear that IT is getting more and more complicated. Especially over the last several years, we know that workers are distributed. We've got people working from different environments. We know that there are new devices coming online. Lots of users have multiple devices and multiple app platforms. Employee satisfaction has become top of mind. We want end users to have easy and fast access to corporate resources, and we want them to have a corporate experience that mimics their personal device experience. And of course, on top of all of this, cybersecurity is always top of mind. We need to make sure that all of our end users that are accessing corporate resources from multiple devices and multiple locations are doing so safely and securely, mitigating any risks of potential vulnerabilities. We hear from IT pros that with this complexity, it's very hard to keep up with all of the changes. The new devices, new apps, new working environments. IT is really looking to move the needle rather than just keep the lights on. But at the same time, budgets are shrinking. IT departments are being asked to do more with less. And we really see intelligence and automation as the way that we can help you achieve this. Our vision is to deliver this intelligent automation to empower you to get the most value out of Microsoft 365 so that you can achieve the best experience for your end users with the least amount of effort. We do this through a three-pronged approach. It starts with giving you real-time visibility into what's going on in your organization. We layer on top of that intelligent recommendations on where you need to be focusing your attention. And then we provide orchestration and remediation actions so that you can act on the insights that are being shared and make sure that you're keeping your end user devices secure and productive. To deliver on this vision, we've released a set of advanced features for endpoint analytics available in Microsoft Intune Suite. Our first round of features includes custom device scopes, which is going to allow you to slice your endpoint analytics reports, scores, and insights using the scope tags in your environment. Our anomaly detection feature is going to proactively identify potential issues within your environment that may have an impact on your end users. And lastly, our enhanced device timeline gives you contextual information at the device level so that you can investigate issues and start to troubleshoot. Let's start by diving into custom device scopes. Now, custom device scopes are all about enabling granular analysis. This isn't just filtering. This is going to allow you to slice your endpoint analytics reports. You'll be able to see scores, insights, recommendations, everything tailored to a specific subset of your enrolled devices. And best of all, custom device scopes are going to build on top of your existing scope tags to allow you to use endpoint analytics in the same way that you're already managing your devices. For instance, you may want to see endpoint analytics insights specific to a particular business group, like human resources. You may want to see insights specific to a particular geography, like North America. Custom device scopes are going to allow you to do this. So I've got a couple screens here to give you a sense of how this works. Let's take a look. When you jump into an endpoint analytics report, you'll notice that we've added a new device scope bar. This is where you're going to go to select the slice that you'd like to view in this endpoint analytics report. By clicking in, you get your menu where you can select the slice or create a new one. So let's click on that Manage Device Scopes down there. And this is going to bring up our Manage Device Scopes flyout. Here's where you go to create these custom device scopes. You'll leverage your existing scope tags. So you can select a scope tag that already exists, or you can go create a new scope tag if you'd like to use a new set of devices. You'll save the custom device scope, give it a name, and then you'll be able to interact with it in Endpoint Analytics. So if we jump back to that device scope menu, this is where I'd go to select a custom device scope. Let's say I want to filter my report here to my early adopters group. I can select that early adopters group device scope. And then when I click apply, you'll notice that the report is going to update. All of the insights, the scores, the data, all the drill downs are going to be filtered and sliced to that early adopters group that I've selected. And best of all, this custom device scope is going to follow me as I move throughout the Endpoint Analytics tool. For instance, if I click over to the device performance report, I'm only going to see devices that exist within that custom device scope. If I click over to restart frequency, still going to be sliced to that early adopters group. So custom device scopes is going to give you that granularity that IT departments are looking for. You'll be able to look at insights, scores, recommendations specific to a subset of your devices. You'll even be able to compare different populations if you'd like to see how one geography is doing relative to another, or even one business group relative to another group. In addition to custom device scopes, we've also got new features around anomaly detection and an enhanced device timeline. Now I'll turn it back over to Lavanya, who's going to share more.
Thanks, Zach. Now we are going to understand more about the other two features of advanced endpoint analytics, which is anomaly detection and enhanced device timeline. Now let's understand more about each of these, right? Traditionally, we have all undergone issues related to laptops restarting unexpectedly, battery dying down unexpectedly, microphone stopped working. Do you know how common these issues are in your organization? How many end users reported these issues? Probably none, maybe few. What do we do about it? Traditionally, IT has had limited visibility into these problems. They either just know about the subset of the issues reported via support channel or higher authority, which are not true representation of what's going on in your organization. Spending countless hours staring at custom dashboards trying to troubleshoot is never fun for an IT admin. Endpoint analytics does collect a wide variety of signals related to endpoint performance and reliability. However, it can be challenging to easily identify current issues like devices with multiple stop error restarts or application hangs and crash. This is where anomaly detection comes in handy, where anomaly detection is an early warning mechanism system for IT admins to become aware of end user impacting issues before they reach through other channels. It helps minimize loss of productivity due to misbehaving devices, apps, and/or infrastructures. Anomalies surfaced are of high confidence and based on severity, starting with those that impact productivity the most. Now, anomaly detection without really understanding what's happening on a given device also could be challenging, which is where anomaly detection blends very well into the enhanced device timeline, wherein the enhanced device timeline is a view of important events that have occurred on a specific device over time. With additional events and lower latency, the enhanced device timeline enables streamlined troubleshooting of end user impacting issues. It also includes important events such as boots, logon, stop error restarts, app crashes, and detected anomalies. Now, what are some of the scenarios we have primarily focused on as part of advanced endpoint analytics is related to app crash and app hang, potential factors influencing the anomaly and suggested remediation. The other key scenario is around stop error restarts, timely detection on impacted devices, and prevention from further impact. Looking into the actual working of both these features put together is what this demo is all going to be about. And let's see what this demo looks like. Anomaly detection is that early warning mechanism that IT admins can rely upon to learn about user impacting issues. This anomaly surfaces on the overview blade alongside model and device score, and the anomalies are surfaced in the order of severity. Anomalies system metadata page gives important information, and to understand more about the affected devices, you click on the View Affected Devices tab to identify the devices alongside important information like manufacturer, model, user experience, OS version. Now, once you click on a specific device, you will see the list of events surfacing on this device, wherein it could be related to boot logon app crash, like we previously discussed, or it could be a source related to anomaly detection that surfaces on this device timeline. This is a very important step helping our customers and IT admins understand what's going on with the device and how to help troubleshoot and remediate in a timely manner. Troubleshooting has never been easier before. Now that we have seen how anomaly detection and device timeline work together seamlessly, we want to understand what's next. Anomaly detection will monitor the health of devices in your organization for user experience and productivity regressions. We also plan on adding more signals like network connectivity, battery health, policy-related information, device compliance-related insights. That'll be very helpful in understanding and troubleshooting the device further. These anomalies are then going to be correlated with important configuration events related to the device in context of an operating system upgrade, a security update, driver install update, or an app installer update, which eventually helps admins with troubleshooting things in a much faster pace. Now, all this is going to be possible only when we have our customers who are able to leverage advanced endpoint analytics feature, but for that, devices must be enrolled in endpoint analytics. Advanced endpoint analytics feature are available as part of the Microsoft Intune Suite announced in the month of March. Your global or billing administrator can start trial or purchase licenses. Advanced endpoint analytics features are enabled automatically when your tenant has an Intune Suite subscription. There are useful resources that we would like to share with you for you to get started. With that, we come to the end of the demos, and we really look forward to you trying out Advanced Endpoint Analytics as part of Microsoft Intune Suite. Thank you, and we are always here to answer your questions.